We use a lot of aluminium objects, but where does all this aluminium come from? It comes from bauxite, which is a red sedimentary rock with irregular white spots composed mainly of aluminium and iron oxides and hydroxides. Bauxite is a very important raw material since it is the main source of aluminium. What can we say about it? Aluminium is the element number 13 of the periodic table. It is presented as a silver-white metal, resistant but at the same time easily workable, resistant to oxidation and light, and this makes it inclined to fabricate many objects of daily use. As I said before, bauxite is used to produce aluminium, but how can we use this metal? Aluminium is the third element most present on the Earth's crust, another factor favoring the use of aluminium in many products. This chemical element is based on many very useful and used products, such as almost all means of transport, many packages, buildings, household appliances and tools, power lines, machinery, binoculars, weapons from fire and bullets. We have therefore seen how important aluminium is, so now it is important to find out how we get it. In fact, there are two ways: to obtain it through the extraction of bauxite or through recycling. Let's start with the first way. To begin, bauxite is collected in open-air deposits and it is customary to prepare plans for the reintegration of landscape before excavation begins, so that the territory is recovered for the reforestation or any other form of reintegration appropriated to the environment. Bauxite is extracted mainly in Australia, in Brazil, in West Africa and in West Indies, and also in some tropical and subtropical regions. Now, if you want to obtain aluminium, you have to undergo two processes: the Bayer process, where you obtain alumina from bauxite, and the Olerud process, where alumina merges with a special material, the cryolite, to obtain aluminium. So aluminium will be welded and you can transform into whatever shape you want. The second way is the recycling process. The aluminium recycling process starts with the subdivision of the various components of a certain product. Taking for example a bicycle, you have to separate the many different components: the aluminium frame, the wheels, chain, etc. Once the components are separated and you have the oil and pure aluminium, this is sent to recycling plants and is transformed into aluminium bales. These aluminium bales, after short checks on the state of the aluminium, are treated at 500 degrees to eliminate paints or other substances that represent impurities in order to finally get the oil and pure aluminium. Finally, the aluminium is taken and melted at 800 degrees. Then it rips into molds and makes ingots out of them. Here the recycling process ends with aluminium. Recycling aluminium is therefore extremely important, especially on an ecological level. First of all, aluminium can be recycled indefinitely without losing its qualities. Furthermore, only 5% of the amount of energy used for actual production is used for the recycling of aluminium. This energy saving saves an average of 8 tons of CO2 per recycling. By limiting the production of aluminium starting from bauxite, environmental disasters can also be avoided, such as the current risk of extinction of chimpanzees in Guinea or like others that have already happened. Then, let's recycle.
Aluminium has excellent recycling properties. You need only 5% of the initial energy from primary production. Aluminium production started back in 1896. Because of the excellent recycling properties of aluminium, still 70% of this aluminium is in use. By recycling aluminium, we are avoiding a lot of CO2 emissions. Today already we avoid 80 million tons of CO2. That is the equivalent of 15 million cars.